Yes, sir. I would not have done it if you were not offering $106. What? What do you mean? Oh shit, there's more of them.
We need some extra lubricant to oil the machinery of business.
Like, shouldn't know that lube for?
Red Dead Redemption.
We're back.
I had to take off the beanie. I couldn't do it. My hair was getting all itchy and shit. Maybe beanies just aren't for me. But anyways, welcome back, everybody. Hope you guys are doing well. I know this mission is right here, but I think I'm gonna do this one in hopes that we could progress in finding Bill. Because everything like build related is in that town. So I'm hoping I'm right. See what Mr. Dickens wants. Oh, hell no. Hold up. Let me help her. Move, bitch. Oh, I thought he was just like messing with her, but nah, he was stabbing her. Man, we should go to the hospital, the doctors. Oh, okay. You're just gonna walk it off? Okay. Back tomorrow, but it's already here.
Excellent to see you today.
Is he still not good?
No.
I can tell you with no uncertainty that miracle cures are no laughing matter. I bid you good day, sir. Oh, Mr. Marston, good to see you. How have you been keeping?
I'm well, Mr.
Mr. West Dickens. Nigel West Dickens of East Cheap, London, New Waverly, New York, and at your service.
At my service?
At everyone's service. At the service of science, of knowledge, of life.
How are your wounds?
Much, much better. But then they would be.
Would be?
I know a cure for all ailments, Mr. Marston.
Ah, I'm sure you do. And I'm sure for just $2 an ounce, I could live forever.
Oh, but for you, sir, I'd do a bulk discount rate of $1.95 an ounce. As long as you buy 100 ounces or more. That's a lot of immortality.
Give it up, old man.
This man's trying to tax me.
Dickens to you, boy.
Give it up, old man.
Listen, Marston, stuff is good. It works. I need a healthy young man like you. Come along, let's ride over to my newest customer at Ridgewood, and I'll explain while we go.
Bruh.
Okay.
Head for Ridgewood Farm, John, and hurry. There are people there in dire need of my tonic.
Yes! Get your cute ass!
I don't know why they did that. That's a horrible placement for a button.
Friends, hardworking souls of Chola Springs, gather round. Do you suffer from rheumatism, lumbago, chronic sciatic,
uncle,
neurologic or inflammatory pain? Well, I represent the only company that makes the genuine article that cures headaches, neuralgia, earache, toothaches, backache, swelling, sprains, sore chests, swelling of the throats, contracted cords and muscles, anxieties and ravaged nerves.
Bro, ain't nobody believing him.
Dislocations, cuts and bruises, and it adds vitality and vigor to the healthy man.
But can you prove it, old man?
Oh, I'm sure there's some customer here who could prove the qualities of its by... Take a drink right now. You, sir, come up here. Step right up.
No, I see. So I'm his guinea pig.
That's the spirit. Ladies and gentlemen, pay close attention. This poor, wretched volunteer...
Bro, I'm not drinking that. I don't even know what's in there.
...demonstrate the effects of Dr. West Dickens' own patent tonic. Be you a cowpoke or athlete, this miraculous elixir developed with the wisdom of the East keeps the muscles supple and relaxes the cords. It loosens the joints and gives a feeling of youth and vigor to the whole system. Not possible, I hear you say. Well, doubt no longer. Faith can move. move mountains, but I ask not for faith. I am a man of science, and today science will be vindicated. Your eyesight is greatly improved. Is that not so, friend?
If you say so.
That's right, it is. You heard him. What a good sport you are, sir. Now, gaze over yonder at that porch. If you squint, you may just be able to make out the skull that's hanging there.
Bro, I could see it from...
Go ahead, friend. Shoot that skull and demonstrate the miraculous eyesight you now possess.
Bro, you better be paying me good.
Remarkable! The eyesight of an eagle, granted by imbibing Dr. West Dickens' own patent tonic.
Anybody can make that shot. This man is a fraud. If your eye is so damn sharp, why don't you try shooting my hat out of the air?
Say less.
Our test case has been challenged to shoot a gentleman's hat out of the sky above our heads.
Oh.
You can fool these people, but you ain't fooling me.
Right. Okay.
Let's just see how sharp you is with a moving target.
All right, I'm gonna show you.
Right, then.
Go.
Here comes the throw.
Throw it. One shot can be fired for each bullet in your gun.
You're more crooked than a snake in a...
Hey.
Seen such an eye. Behold the power.
I wasn't doubting myself.
Plucked out of the sky.
Hey. Hey. What? You think you can put a hole in a man's hat and just walk away? Do you?
That's literally what you wanted. Bro, you want to throw hands? We could throw hands.
A challenge of battle has been offered to our volunteer.
Put him up, put him up. Are you gonna show me how to fight? Oh my gosh. I'm talking all that shit, I'm about to get my ass beat. Ground tackle, oh, what the fuck? I did not know you could do that. Fuck, easy for me. How do I dodge? Show me how to dodge. Okay, there it is. Go, swing at me. Is this to block? What is... Fuck. Mink, bitch, go to sleep. Man was all talk.
Center's irrefutable proof. Do not let this opportunity pass you by.
Look, he's over there. Go get
him. Of course.
Watch out! He's got a gun.
Who the hell do you think you
are? I'm not even surprised, bro. It'd be like that. Then did I target your opponent's gun used to shoot the gun out of his hand?
That can only be afforded by the West Dickens elixir.
It has nothing to do with the elixir. We're just like that. I feel like he might come back, like later on in the game.
No harm in trying one bottle, I suppose.
Well, I think that went kind of well, don't you?
I'm just glad that my normal job involves either chasing after cattle or murderers. Not the likes of you, mister.
Don't be like that.
Now, if you'll excuse me,
it's my money. Yet.
Say my goodbyes. Head on back to the real world.
Wait, sir. I've been thinking.
Wasn't he gonna pay us?
And I think I may have an idea. I've been thinking I could be your cunning Odysseus. Beware of the Greeks bearing gifts, sir. Mm-hmm. Williamson had better beware. We will make them into Trojans.
I don't rightly get you.
I want you to go and see my old friend Seth. He can come across as a little curious, but I'm sure you two will get on. He's most often found at Coots Chapel. He's very devout.
Why see him?
Because between him and me, we can get those gates to open for you, and you can walk right in, just like in Homer's great Trojan yarn!
How much money is this? 160? Oh, say less. I'm doing it. 160, bro. The other one was like 50. This one is triple that. Is that him? I think this is him. Lasso. Come here. Come here. Can I tie him? I'll tie you up. That has to be him, bro. I swear if it's not him. This is him. The other one wasn't him. That didn't kill you? You found that no good piece of dirt. Thank you. Yes, sir. I would not have done it if you were not offering $106. What? What do you mean? So you're Seth, huh? What is he, like a grave digger?
Come on then, partner.
So next time, I'm gonna just put my controller down and not touch it.
Can you take that low? Digging up graves and looting from the
dead. Oh, he was looting.
Ah, hypocrite. The whole damn lot of you. Are you saying it's better to steal from the living? They're corpses. They don't care none.
These people have been laid to rest.
You don't know nothing. I talk to them long after they've been forgotten by every other fellow. I tell them it's all right to be scared and alone. I embrace them when they're stinking and rotten.
I met some sick bastards in my time, Seth. But you, you're special.
Folk is cold and heartless all their lives. To me, they get warmer when they're actually cold and heartless. Surely that makes sense to even you.
Not exactly, it don't.
Are we really living anyway? Do you exist outside my mind? Maybe we're both having the same dream, and when we wake up, we'll die.
I certainly seem to be in some kind of nightmare.
Thought it was like a gravedigger or something, but now he was looting them. That's crazy. That's why you don't skip the cutscenes.
What'd you say?
I didn't say nothing.
I just heard you say something.
You're a crazy man. You should get that head looked at.
Seth, I need someone who can get a wagon inside Fort Mercer. I was told you could help me, but I'm not sure you even know what day it is.
I don't. I can't even tell you what year it is.
I knew this was a waste of time.
So, you want to go after Bill Williamson, do you? You
know goddamn Bill? Right.
Oh, yes. I'm at Williamson and Deacon. All them boys. Sometimes they call me on when they get some special job needs doing. I got a reputation as a man who do things most other fellas want.
Now, that I can believe.
I reckon you can get in there, no bother. Assuming you help me find this math addict.
Oh, I thought we were stealing them. Robbing them, I mean.
What's so important about this math?
Nothing much. Just unimaginable riches and such like. A spark of hope that lit a rage and fire I can't put out.
I thought as much. Another treasure hunter losing everything in the search for nothing.
Oh, I lost it all, partner. My wife, my children, my business. Good riddance to them all. I don't eat, I don't sleep, I don't wash, and I don't care.
I know. I can smell you from here.
It used to be about the money, but now I'm looking at somebody else. Only it's me, you know?
Maybe it's time you moved on.
No way I can stop now. It's taking me over. Let's stop here a moment and come up with a plan.
Okay, put it down.
As far as I know, Moses is being held in that shack. There's a couple of deputies keeping guard outside. Can you distract him so I can sneak in for a quick parlay with that son of a bitch?
I'm sure I can think of something.
Leave them away from the shack and out of sight. Somewhere out past that hill.
Oh, steal a horse.
This is one god awful assassin.
Go, 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 go. $20? That's all I'm worth? Wow. Oh, shit. No, 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 no. Get back up, get back up. Fuck, go. They're coming. I need to remember that's what happens when you run out of stamina. Fuck is again? Yeah, no shit.
Come on. Come on, come on.
Oh, it's going away, it's going away. Kinda like GTA. Stay hidden from law enforcement. So this is good here. Yeah.
Getting rid of them clowns. Now keep an eye out in case they come back. Moses?
Get that slippery bastard! I need him alive, though!
Bruh.
Who the hell are you?
I'm reaching him. Last one. I missed. There we go.
God damn you! Let me go! I'm begging you!
Sorry, Moses. Can't do that.
Been a twisty little freak. I ain't telling you shit.
Then I'm gonna cut you up piece by piece till you find your tongue.
Friend, this man's gone crazy in the sun. I suggest you take my advice and start talking.
Shut up, Marston. I want to cut into a bona fide man's flesh. Ain't never cut into a live one before.
That's it.
Odd fellow's rest. It's an odd fellow's rest. Get away from me once and for all.
Well, ain't that a damn shame? I was starting to enjoy myself. I think you gotta fix yourself.
Those deputies went and put a bounty on your head. Best we clear it now. Don't need the law on our backs. I don't have no money, but I got me a pardon letter. Here, take it. You earned
it's a pardon
it for
letter.
Moses. Come on, we can pay it off in the telegraph office. Come on, ain't no time to be wasting.
Drunken rustler told me he
what if I save it, and I just paid the $20 now, so when, like, a bigger bounty gets on my head, I could pay that.
Go speak to that fella.
Yeah, I'm going to pay him my $20. Hopefully it works like that. If not, then I just fucked up.
So, mister, thanks for your help.
That's it?
Don't worry yourself with thanks, Seth. Just help me when I come asking.
No problem, mister.
Dude, there's some errant wrongdoers down the way. Seem to have eluded us. Round them up or shoot them down.
I'll just capture you. You're lucky you're not getting the same thing your boy did. Oh shit, there's more of them. No, take out your Mark John. What? Let's see what he wants again.
Oh, Mr. Marston, how are you, sir?
I'm all right. I met up with your friend Seth.
Oh, Seth of the Dead, yes.
Seth of the Dead.
Fellow. You don't meet many men these days with the moral fortitude to cut straight to the chase like that, do you?
Thankfully not, Mr. West Dickens.
Yes, contemporary society is remarkably harsh on professional exhumers. But did you know that in ancient Egypt, it was an art form valued more highly than literature? I believe Seth comes
I'm calling
from that
cab.
School of thought.
How very interesting. Look, you thought any more about our plan?
Ah, your plan, dear boy, your plan. I am merely the help, not mercifully the arbiter of wisdom.
What you are, dear boy, is the man whose life I've saved twice now. A man who sells lies and deceit to unwitting people. A man who, if he doesn't help me, I won't think twice about putting a bullet
hell
through
yeah.
his skull. Feeding to the vultures myself.
You see, Mr. Marston, you have the exterior of a violent man, but the soul of an angel, and that is what I think I cherish most about you.
Bro, I'm getting tired of him.
That's what I thought.
But before we can...
I'm given the option to shoot him.
Particular problems,
put him one in his dome.
We need some extra lubricant to oil the machinery of business, and this being America... That lubricant with which we concern ourselves,
like,
is
money. Shouldn't know that lube for.
What do you mean by that? Money? What are you talking about?
Oh, we need weapons, armor plate for the wagon, extra hands, and I need some danger money.
So, let's sell some more of these cures.
Sell cures? Around here? Do you want to see me lynched? Oh, no. The sport of kings. Racing, my friend. The sport of kings. A noble activity without reproach. Exactly the kind of activity where a lying, cheating, degenerate like myself can prosper.
At least you're self-aware.
Come, let's finish the loading and we'll discuss it as we drive.
So does he want me to do a horse race?
Now, sir, do yap, do preach.
That's what I'm getting from all this yapping. Wait. horse racing. That is what he wanted. I just wish I could hear the conversation, but my dumbass skipped it. I'm so stupid, bro. Get on the car to start race. Which one? Oh, this one? No, I do not know the rules. Ooh, this might not go good. Go, what are you doing? Can we ram into them? Oh, I need to save my stamina. What the fuck was that? Oh, I'm tripping. I thought they were like sabotaging or some shit. I'm in first place. Shooting other racers will cause you to be no shit. I know that. They don't cheat around here. The stamina is going down. Oh shit, this way. I was about to run him over. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Got me drifting a horse. Did it.
Hell of a race, mister. I'll take care of this cart for Mr. West Dickens.
Come on, son. I suggest we take patience.
Good looking out.
We do not care.
Well done, sir. Well done. Having you as a ringer has netted us a fine profit.
We seem to be wasting time, old man.
Oh, hell yeah,
patience,
we are.
Patience, my friend. The Trojan horse cannot run before it can walk, if you'll forgive the metaphor. Next, we need to procure some grand and overwhelming firepower. And for that, you need to contact an old friend of mine. Goes by the name of Irish.
Irish?
Yes, he's an interesting kind of fellow. He usually can be found in Armadillo or some other town around here on some Bacchanalian revel or such.
Great. An alcoholic arms dealer.
What could be better?
$3. This dude gave me $3.